So the first plugin that we are going to take a look at is all-in-one WP migration. Now this plugin exports all your WordPress files and folders, including your database, media files, pages, posts, comments, authors, plugins, themes, and so on, almost everything. It exports your entire website with no technical knowledge required into one single file. Now this is very important, because if you go to export your file normally manually, it's just so difficult and it requires a lot of technical knowledge. But using this plugin, you can export it very easily, very quickly into one single file. And now tomorrow, if you want to move your website to some other domain, suppose if you have one domain and if you want to move your website to some other domain, you can simply export the files from here and go to the new domain and import everything, and you will have a exact same website, the clone of the original website. So very, very useful plugin, and it is very, very easy to use and to export and import the website using this plugin. Now let me show you this. When you download and install the plugin, you'll get this thing over here, this menu over here at the left hand side. You'll see all-in-one WP migration. When you hover this, you'll see export, import, and backup. When you click on export, here as you can see, now you can click on this button, export to file, FTP, Dropbox, Google Drive, and so on. So we want to export to file. So you select this file. Now it is exporting your website. It will take some time, a few seconds or few minutes. As you can see, it is exporting around 6,000 files, but it will not take much time, don't worry. So once it is ready, you will have one file downloaded, and you go to other website, you download the same plugin, and instead of export, you click on import. Then you select import from file and you select that file, whatever that file is, and your website will be completely changed. So very, very useful plugin. I recommend everyone to use this plugin. Very useful. It will always help you, and it is a very good, well-rated plugin. Now the second plugin that we are going to take a look, in fact the second plugin is related to a category. What I do is, normally when I create these kind of videos, I try to cover all kind of plugins. Okay, I don't cover only the page builders or just one category. I don't cover just one category. I try to cover all the different categories. For example, a website for security, website for page building, and website for your performance, and so on and so forth. Okay, so I try to cover all the categories. So the second website or the second plugin is related to image optimization category. Now there are two plugins that I recommend in this category. Okay, so the first one is WP Smush, and the second one is, I think that it is called ShortPixel image optimizer, if I'm not wrong. Now image optimization plugin is very, very useful and very, very important. What it does is it optimizes your image, it compresses your image. Suppose you have many different images on your website, and this is very important plugin for people who have many different images on your website. Okay, so what it does is it optimizes and compresses your image. So the this for example, your image size is a full width size, for example 1920 into 1080p pixel image. What this will do is it will compress the size, because a normal image of that size will be around 2 or 3 MB, but what this will do is it will compress it and make it around 200-300 KB. So very, very useful, and you will not face any, you know, change in the quality of the image. The quality will remain the same, only the size will decrease. Okay, the size will also remain the same, only the file size will decrease. Okay, so very, very important. Now this indirectly affects your SEO ranking, because once your images are compressed, it will increase the page speed and decrease the page load time. And once that happens, you will gain better SEO ranking and Google will rank you higher. So very, very, very important plugin again. Now suppose you download this plugin, for example, if you download Smush, you'll see an option over here, Smush, you can see at the bottom left hand side. Now here, as you can see, around 340 images has been smushed or compressed. Then you, if you want to, whenever you upload a new image, it will be compressed automatically. Okay, so very, very useful plugin. Now the third plugin in our list is OrbitFox by TinyMCE. Now this is a very cool plugin, because what it does is it extends the functionality of your theme. It adds many different features in your theme and on or in your website. It has many different modules like social media, share buttons, and icons, uptime monitoring, Google Analytics. You can add menu icons in your menu. Okay, so you can add icons in your menu bar. It also has one click import page template option, and you get many templates, page templates, which are supported by Elementor as well. Now, when you download this plugin, you'll see a new option over here, OrbitFox. And when you hover over this, you'll see that two different options. When you click on the second one, template directory, you'll see there are so many pre-built page layouts, professional page layouts you can import directly on your website using Elementor. Okay, so this is related to Elementor. And we click on general settings, you'll see there are so many different modules available. You can activate or deactivate them if you want. The first one is social sharing module, uptime monitor. So first module adds those social, beautiful social sharing buttons on your website, on your post, on your pages. The second module, which is uptime monitor, whenever your website is down, your server is down, it will email you that, you know, your website and server is down and what you should do next. Now, the third one is analytics integration. This is a very nice module because you can, integrate your Google Analytics with your website very easily. Then you have template directory module. You can add icons to your menus. Then there are many different beautiful things. For example, as I said, you can add icons to your menu. So what you can do, you can hover appearances, go to menus. Okay, now when you come over here, if you see, let's expand this. When you expand this, you'll see this option over here, icon, and you can select icon. For example, this is the home page. So you can search home over here and you'll see a related, okay, you can see this icon. You can use this icon for your home menu, okay? So very, very useful plugin again. So this was our third plugin. Now our fourth plugin is TinyMCE Advanced. Now this plugin lets you add, remove and arrange buttons that are shown on your visual editor toolbar, and it makes it more user friendly. You can configure up to 4 rows of button, including font size. Now earlier without this plugin, we were not able to, make font sizes in your visual composer or in your visual editor toolbar. But with this, you can change font size, font family, background color and so on. Now let me show you this. Now let's create a new post. So let's hover post and click on add new. Okay, now if you see over here, this doesn't look like the ordinary page editor. You have some different options over here. You have these things at the top. You can create tables using this. You can see very easily. You can change font size, which was not possible. This is possible all because of TinyMCE Advanced. You can see, you can change the font size from here. You can have a background color, text color. Text color was present, but you can also have background color and so on. And you can also change this format. Suppose you don't want these things over here, and if you don't want this paragraph thing over here, so you can do that as well. So what you can do is, you can, I think you can hover appearances or maybe settings, I guess. Let's see. Where is setting? Yeah, here it is. You can hover settings and you'll have this option, TinyMCE Advanced. Now when you click on this, you can see you can integrate it, and you can do everything according to your choice. You can make some changes over here. Suppose I don't want this thing, I can drag it over here under unused button. And if I want something new, then I can just, for example, I want this thing mark, I can bring it over here. Okay, so this is how easy it is. You can use emotions, emojis here in over here. You can add this icon at the top. Okay, now you can add some more things. For example, you can add a new line. Okay, it's all up to you. So very, very useful plugin. I really like this. It is very helpful. You will understand when you, if you have created a website, if you already own a WordPress website and you want to create posts, you will understand the use and need for this one. And you also have this beautiful thing over here which says code. Whenever you want to insert some HTML, CSS code, it is very difficult to do with the regular page editor or visual editor. But with this, you can easily do it, and it will display as HTML and CSS code on your website. Okay, so very, very easy. Okay, guys, now let's move on to the fifth plugin. The fifth plugin in our list is Black Studio TinyMCE Widget. Now this is also related to this visual editor. Okay, so what this plugin does is it adds a new visual editor widget that allows you to insert rich text and media objects in your sidebars, okay, without any problem, without any technical knowledge. Okay, so this is also very important. Earlier, what was happening? Let me explain you this. First, let me just deactivate this plugin, Black Studio TinyMCE, and after that, we can understand the difference. Okay, so here it is. Let me deactivate this. Okay, and let me go to widgets. Okay, hover appearances, open this widgets tab in a new tab. All right, now earlier when you want to add some text over here, let me show you. Here we have text. Let's add over here. So when you want to add text, you have only these options. This is the default WordPress options. Okay, you can make it bold, italic, you can, but only these five options. But if you want those more options like we have when we add the post, you can activate this plugin. Let's activate and let's see again what happens. So we have activated it. Let's refresh this. Okay, now when you see, when you scroll down, you'll see a new option, visual editor. Now we can add this widget over here and you'll see all these beautiful options over here. So you can, and we also get those TinyMCE Advanced, the earlier plugin option as well. Okay, we have all these options over here. So very, very easy to do. You can add beautiful things in your sidebar and in your, you know, footer as well. So very useful plugin again. Now the sixth plugin in our list is UpdraftPlus WordPress backup plugin. It is a backup plugin. It is a very, very easy, and the most important thing is it is free. It has got more than 1 million active installs. There are more than 1 million websites in the world which has still activated, which has this plugin activated on their website. So you can understand how important and how useful this plugin is. Now this makes your backups and your restoration very, very easy. It is the world's highest ranking and most popular backup plugin. You can schedule your backup. It's very easy. You can upload your backup or keep your backup on different locations. For example, you can upload your backup on Dropbox, Google Drive, and so on, or you can have them on your local computer. Very, very easy, very useful plugin. Now let's see how this works. Now, if you want to use this one, you get one option. When you hover settings, you'll see this UpdraftPlus backups. When you click on this, you'll see the options. Here it is. You can just click on this button to backup now, and it will backup all your files. You'll get a new file. What you can do is you can schedule this. Okay, so let us see. We can go to settings, and here you have files backup schedule. Okay, so you can backup every 12 hours, every day, every week, every month. And you can select where you want to save your backups. You can select Dropbox, and when you select Dropbox, you have to put in your Dropbox credentials below. When you select FTP, you have to put in your FTP credentials below. So very, very useful free backup plugin, very useful. And as I said you earlier, it is very popular. More than 1 million websites have actively installed this plugin on their website. Now the seventh plugin in our list is Ad Inserter by Igor Funa. Now this is a very, very useful and very simple plugin. Now many people complain that they are not able to add those Google ads on their website. They are getting that problem, that script is not loading this and that. So, you know, I do understand it is a bit, you know, tricky to do it for the first time when you're doing that for the first time, inserting ads on your website. You know, the location, you have to choose the location where you want to add. Sometimes it doesn't work and so on and so forth. Now this plugin simplifies your work. This is the best ad management plugin with many advanced advertising features, and it supports all kind of WordPress ads, including your Google AdSense, contextual Amazon native shopping ads, media.net ads, and rotating banners, and so on. And also you get so many different and advanced options and features with this plugin. Now let's see how this works. When you download this plugin, you get this option, Ad Inserter, under settings. You click on this Ad Inserter and you can see this screen. Now what happens is you have to copy and paste your Google ad script over here. Okay, so whatever the code you get, ad code, you have to paste it over here. And you can see you have different blocks, like block 1, block 2, block 3. So suppose you have inserted your code under block 1, then you get many options, you know, many automatic options. For example, if you want to add, or if you want to show these ads on every post, you can select this thing, or you can select only individually enabled or individually disabled, or if you want to show these ads on your homepage, you can select this homepage. If you want to show these ads on search pages, you can select these things and so on. You can also convert this ad under shortcodes. You can just simply tick mark over here. It will convert this ad into shortcode. And whenever you want to upload this ad, you simply copy this shortcode from here and paste it wherever you want to show this ad. Suppose you want to show your ad under some post, you can simply paste in this shortcode under the post. If you want to show this ad on your sidebar, you add a new widget, text widget, and you add this shortcode over there. So very, very useful plugin. Again, very useful. You can earn a lot of money using this plugin, obviously by using Google AdSense and so on. And it simplifies your work. Very useful plugin. Now the 8th plugin that we are going to look is actually here. So you have two options. This is a form builder. So you have two options over here. You have WP Forms. And you also have Ninja Forms, so you can use any one of those. Both are almost the same. So if you're using Ninja Forms, you can hover over here. You'll get this option, Ninja Forms. You can hover over here, click on Add New. I'm not including WP Forms over here because I have included that plugin in the earlier video. Okay. Now when you do so, you'll get many different options. For example, there are pre-made layouts for you. Okay. Suppose you want to create a form to maybe for event registration. So you can just simply click over here and you'll get a pre-made form. Let us see how it looks. Okay, you have this first name, last name, email address, any food requirement. And when you click on this, you can see this is actually a radio list. You can select vegan, you can select whatever you want. Okay, vegetarian, so on and so forth. And you can add or delete something from here. For example, if you don't want this phone number from here, you can simply click on over here and you can delete it. Let us see where we have this option. Or you don't click it, I guess. You just click on done. You simply hover it and you'll get this option to delete it. Okay, so you can simply delete it from here. Let's click on delete. Okay, I think it is not loading. Don't worry, I think there is some problem with me, my internet connection. Create, as you can see, I'm getting some error over here. And if you want to add some new fields, you can simply click on this plus button. You have so many different options over here related to, you know, different things. If you want single checkbox, you can simply add over here and you have this option. Then you can configure this option and so on. So very, very useful plugin, I would say. Okay. So you can use it according to your choice. So this was our 8th plugin, I guess. Now the 9th plugin on our list is Duplicate Post by Enrico Bertocci. I know I'm pronouncing it wrong, but no problem. Now this plugin also has more than 2 million active installs. So you can understand how famous and useful this plugin can be. Now what happens is, let us first get out from here and let's see how this works. So suppose you click on post, you have different posts. Now I have only one post. Now instead of creating this thing, I can simply clone this post. Okay, so I can copy this post. You can clone at different pages as well. Now I have a copy of this one. I can edit it and this will be a totally different page or totally different post. Okay, so this is very, very useful. You have some more options over here, but basically this is the basic thing that it does. You get some more options. You can go through the plugin page. You'll see what more options do you have. Okay, so but very useful. You can understand why more than 2 million people have actively installed this plugin on their website. So you can understand how useful this can be. Now the last plugin on our list is BJ Lazy Load. Very, very useful plugin. Again, it will improve the performance and speed of your website. Now what this plugin does is does not load. What happens is, suppose someone is viewing or seeing a post or reading a post on your website and that post has many different images. So what happens is if it has many different images, obviously it will take a lot of time to load that page and there are high chances that a user might just exit your website, go to some other website, or they might, you know, not like it, and it is also not good for SEO purposes. Now what this plugin does is it will load your website very fast. And how does this do? Because suppose you have 10 different images on one single post. Okay, so suppose you see this page over here, you have two images over here, and when you scroll down, do we have some more images? Suppose this is also an image. So when you open this page, only these two images will load. Okay. And this image will not load. This image will load. The bottom image will only load when the user scrolls to that section. Now, when the user comes to this section, only then this will load, or else it will not load. And whatever images are present in the bottom, they will not load until and unless I go to that section. I scroll to that section. So very, very important plugin again. Okay, guys. So these were my top 10 free plugin list. I hope you have enjoyed this video. I hope you have found something useful, at least one useful video, plugin for your website. If you like this video, make sure to subscribe to my channel. Also give a thumbs up to this video. You can click on that bell icon so that you don't miss any future videos. If you have any doubt, any queries, any question, any suggestion for me, leave them in the comment section below. And please let me know if you know some useful plugins that you can share with